coronavirus rages its incessant war with human beings. Dramatic changes took place in how people live, learn, interact, and cooperate. Definitely, these changes are unquestionably troubling the whole humanity. It is also opening a unique window through which to observe some positive effects in human beings. When we step into from the traditional classroom to online mode, we face a lot of challenges. Indeed, this pandemic is an eye-opener to the teachers. Eye-opener in the sense to identify the digital knowledge, skills, and talents of the learners. In the present pandemic situation, for the sake of maintaining learners' interest in the online classroom, facilitating meaningful and eventually self-directed learning, I assigned some learning activities to the 10th standard students based on Unit 1, Glimpses of Green, Lesson Adventures in a Banyan Tree. I asked them to prepare a documentary and digital posters for creating awareness on the conservation of nature. To be frank, I'm greatly happy and proud to say that my students have held my head high. All of them have contributed to the project. We cannot say that these works are that of perfect, but I appreciate the process that they have undergone. Self-directed learning, collaborative and cooperative learning, after all, the digital avenues for their learning. So I didn't make an attempt to edit their work. I present my students' documentary and digital poster as they are. I take this opportunity to appreciate the team leaders of all the groups who ensure the participation of their group members. I'm quite sure that our students will go on to do great things since they are smart and talented. I wish all the success in your future endeavors. Happy learning.
Look deep into nature to understand everything better. This is the documentary by the Turquoise Group.
Hi friends, this is Alfie Baiju of class 10th. Today we will see about the problems faced by nature and in what all ways we can prevent them.
Our environment is the place where we live. There must be harmony between the environment and living beings. In the present situation, due to overpollution, the environment is under distress. Environmental pollution is one of the biggest issues that modern world faces today. They are
deforestation,
overpollution,
overuse of plastic.
Yes, overuse of plastic is harmful for the nature. Now, let's hear some words of Aaron about plastic pollution.
Dear friends, we all know plastic is harmful for our health. Plastic pollution is the accumulation of plastic objects and particles in the Earth's environment that adversely affects wildlife habit, and humans. Plastics that act as pollution are categorized. Most importantly, plastic pollution harms the marine life. The plastic litter in the water is mistaken for food by the aquatic animals. We must use alternatives like cloth bags, and paper bags instead of plastic bags. If we are purchasing plastic, we must reuse it.
Thank you, Aaron. So, have you guys listened to Aaron? Now you may have understood the seriousness of overuse of plastic. The most important thing is that many innocent animals are losing their life daily just because of our selfishness. So, to prevent that, stop using plastic. Due to these pollutions, many disasters are also formed. They are
flood, wildfire,
global warming, and soil erosion are the disasters formed by these pollution. Now, let's see what are the other ways to prevent pollution.
Conserve water.
Conserving electricity.
Plant trees as much as possible.
Avoid using cars as much as possible.
Now, I think you guys have understood the problems faced by nature and how to prevent them. Let us all do what we can to save our environment and preserve our resources for the future generations. Thank you.
Nature, it is a gift of God. The nature consists of trees, rivers, mountains, hills, water bodies, and so many beautiful things. The nature is changing second by second, or else the life on earth will feel boring to us. The nature is like our mother. She loves us and gives us everything that is essential for our life. So, we also want to love her back, or else she will show her second face, the deadliest face. She has shown her deadliest face all over the world, including Kerala. Various natural disasters are now taking place on Earth. So many human activities are now resulting in natural disasters. Let's know more about them.
Natural disasters. Natural disasters are destructive events that occur as a result of volcanic, geographical or hydrological factors which can result in death, property destruction, or social and environmental disturbance. Let's see some examples of natural disasters.
The natural disasters include floods, earthquakes, cyclones, tsunamis, landslides, storms, volcano eruptions, heat waves, cold waves, droughts, mud waves, etc. These disasters happen naturally on Earth, but some human activities causes these disasters.
Now let's discuss about some human activities which leads to this above mentioned natural disaster. So many human activities like deforestation, air pollution, river filling, construction of huge buildings and dams, etc. will result in a natural disaster. The phenomena called global warming caused so many natural disasters like cyclone, flood, melting of ice sheets, etc. Let's take a look about global warming.
Global warming, the increase in the amount of greenhouse gases such as carbon dioxide, methane and nitrous oxide, etc. expelled from vehicles and factories result in global warming. This global warming formed due to human activities causes many natural disasters such as cyclone, flood, etc. It also results in climate change and melting of ice sheets. Earth is now losing 1.2 trillion tons of ice each year. And do you know what? One chlorine atom can destroy over 1 lakh ozone molecules. This causes ozone depletion. let's see some natural disasters formed due to human activities. Earthquake. Earthquakes are usually caused when rock underground suddenly breaks along a fault. This sudden release of energy causes the seismic waves that make the ground shake. The earthquake below or near ocean floor causes tsunami. Are you wondering that which human activity results in earthquake? I will tell you. Construction of dams and collapse of roofs of mines causes earthquake. Excessive water pressure in dams results in earthquake.
Flood. Human activities that degrade the environment increase flooding. These activities such as deforestation, climate change, river filling causes flood. The lack of vegetation and water bodies encourage water to flow over the surface rather than infiltrate into the soil, thus increasing surface runoff. We have also experienced flood during 2018.
How can we escape from this disaster? It can be only done by the conservation of nature. As we said in the past, we want to love her. We want to withdraw our cruel activities towards the nature. We want to stop deforestation. We want to stop polluting the air. We want to stop the construction of huge buildings. We want to stop the water pollution. We want to stop polluting the both land and sea with the dumping of plastic materials. We want to reduce, reuse and recycle the plastic waste. We want to promote afforestation instead of deforestation. We can reduce air pollution and global warming by reducing the use of vehicles. Instead of private vehicles, we can make use of public transportation. We can reduce the weight of ozone depletion by decreasing the use of air conditioners and fridges. We can reduce river pollution by stopping the dumping of wastewater. We want to conserve our natural resources for next generation. It is not only belongs to us, so we have to act intelligently.
Our sprawling cities and consumption of fossil fuels also have a direct impact on the environment. These activities are also causing changes in global weather patterns, leading to an increase in natural disasters like floods and wildfires.
The various types of man-made disasters are nuclear disasters, chemical or industrial disaster, technical failures, terrorism, fire outbreaks, epidemic, road and train accidents.
Save environment. Afforestation is another essential way to save our trees and forest. A clean environment is essential for us to lead healthy and fulfilling life. To protect our environment, we must discard plastic and use jute, paper or cloth in its place. We must abide by the laws created by the government regarding our environment. The Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is an example of one such mission.
Building dams can cause earthquakes because of the huge water mass that applies pressure on the surface beneath.
Deforestation, urban development, natural wetland destruction, agricultural activities, hydroelectric power, they all can increase the possibility of having flood.
Man-made disasters are the disasters due to the result of human intense negligence or ingrown failure of man-made system that leads to human suffering and environmental damage.
Cyclones are wind storm accompanied with heavy rainfall at low pressure area. They are caused due to a continuous process of rising of hot air over the ocean surface. This vacant space is then occupied by the cool air around, which further heat up and rise.
Thank you.
Conservation of nature. Conservation of nature is important for livelihood because nature provides many things like food, shelter and many more. If the nature does not exist, where do we live and from where do we get the oxygen that is essential for our existence? We live on the most beautiful planet Earth, which has very attractive nature full of greenery. Nature is our best friend, which provides us with all the resources to live here. This is the most important reason why we call nature our home. And also it gives us water to drink, pure air to breathe, food to eat, land to stay, etc. for our betterment. We should fully enjoy the nature without disturbing its ecological balance. We should care our nature, make it peaceful, keep it clean and prevent it from the destruction so that we can enjoy our nature forever.
Natural disaster. Natural disaster can come about as a result of climatic or geological events. The climate can bring about disasters such as flood, storm, and bushfire. Earthquake, tsunami, and volcanoes are the result of geological events. Natural disaster can affect our community in terms of loss of life, property damage, and impacts on economy. Man-made disaster happens due to human activities such as air pollution, water pollution, and soil pollution. Air pollution has affected nature very badly in many ways. For example, factory releasing harmful pollution to air. Water pollution happens due to industrial waste dumped into the water and household waste etc. to the water. Land pollution is one of the biggest environment problem happens due to the improper waste dumped into the soil and usage of materials that are harmful to our environment.
We can do is limit our polluting activities. we must adopt the three steps of reduce, reuse and recycle to limit the amount of waste we produce.
This is our planet Earth, our home. Our planet is at crossroads when it comes to conserving nature. The ecosystem that underpin our economies, well-being and survival are collapsing. Species are becoming extinct at unprecedented rates. Our climate is in crisis, and it's all happening now. Decisions we make now will have a long-term impact on the health and sustainability of the planet. We have the tools it takes to make a difference. Now is the time to be bold and to act together.
I am Gianna of Class 10C. The planet and its resources make life possible on Earth. To safeguard the existence of life on Earth, we should protect and take care of the Earth. Our friend Devika of Class 10B is here with us to share her ideas on the topic Save Earth.
Today, I am standing here to say about how we can save the Earth. We live on our Earth. We get everything for our life from the Mother Earth. So, we should save our Earth to ensure that the future generations get a safe life in our environment. We can save our Earth by saving trees, natural resources, natural vegetation, water, electricity, etc. If we cut a tree, we want to plant one sapling.
Thank you, Devika. Remember, if we destroy Earth, we are destroying the chance of life. Water and air, the two essential fluids on which life depends, have become global garbage cans. Let's watch a video presentation prepared by Aryananda of Class 10C on the topic pollution.
There are different types of pollutions. First one, air pollution. Air pollution is a mixture of solid particles and gases in the air. Chemicals from factories, dust, pollen and mold spores may be suspended as particles. And second one, water pollution. Water pollution is the contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of human activities. Water bodies include, for example, lakes, rivers, oceans, and groundwater. Water pollution is resulted when contaminants are introduced into natural environment. And third one, land pollution. Soil contamination or soil pollution as part of land degradation is caused by the presence of xenobiotics, chemicals or other alteration in the natural soil environment. Fourth one, noise pollution. Noise pollution can be defined as any disturbing or unwanted noise that interferes or harms humans or wildlife. Noise pollution has a negative impact on wildlife species by reducing habitat quality, increasing stress levels and masking other sounds. And last one, radioactive pollution. Radioactive contamination, also called radiological contamination, is the deposition of or presence of radioactive substance on surface or within solids, liquids or gases with their presence in unhindered or undisturbed.
Let's hear our friends Ridhika and Penina of Class 10B.
I'm Ridhika. My friends have introduced different types of pollution and how to solve it. As I just going to speak about water pollution. Water pollution is a contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of human activities. For example, ocean and river. Thank you.
Hi friends, I am Penina. There are many types of pollutions. Among them, I am going to tell 10 pollutions. Air pollution, water pollution, land pollution, soil pollution, noise pollution, plastic pollution, waste pollution, light pollution. Thank you,
Ridhika and Penina. Humans are the only animals that fouls its own nest. Let's watch a video presentation created by Anu Nixon of Class 10C. On the topic, human activities that lead to natural calamities.
Human activities that lead to natural disasters or man-made disaster.
Man-made disasters are equally devastating, but unlike natural disasters, it results directly from humans' activities. There are multiple factors that may relate to man-made disasters. Weapons, chemicals, carelessly handling danger, illiteracy, unawareness, ignorance. There are different types of man-made disasters are there. Nuclear disaster, fire disaster, deforestation, chemical or industrial disaster, road accident, building and bridge collapse, terrorist attack, etc. So, let us stand as to pay damage to these who sacrifice their lives for the living of all Indians. Thank you.
Protecting nature and preserving it for future generation also mean that the animal we love don't become a distant memory and can maintain a healthy and functional ecosystem. Our friends Ashwini and Anu will tell us how to overcome this pathetic condition of Earth.
Today, I'm here to say a few words about how to save our Earth. Once, Mahatma Gandhi said, Earth provides enough to satisfy every man's needs, but not every man's greed. Earth provides us with food, shelter and most of our equipment, but we are not able to pay off her kindness to us. Rather, we humans are being cruel to our Earth with our selfish activities.
So, it's our turn to fulfill our responsibility. Many ways are there through which can protect our Mother Earth. Plant trees and save trees as much as you can. More trees will help you to reduce the carbon dioxide in the air. And protect, try to use the public transport that our own vehicles refrigerator in our home. Omit CFC which depletes the ozone layer.
Opt for organic than chemical. Replace fossil fuels with green energy like solar panels, natural gas. Always keep these three words in your mind. Reduce, reuse, recycle. Use less and save for our future generation. Thanks.
Hello friends, I am Ashwini. My friends are all ready to explain different types of pollution. I am going to tell about how to overcome this pollution. Reduce the number of trips you take in your car. And another one is reduce the eliminate fireplace and wood stove use. Thank you.
Beings depend on Earth for their survival, and so we should use the gift of the nature in a thoughtful way. It's the responsibility of every individual to save our planet. If preventive measures are not taken, our future generation will have to face severe problems. So friends, be a part of the solution, not a part of the pollution. Thank you. In every walk with nature, one receives far more than he seeks. It's difficult to describe the miraculous beauty of nature. It might be difficult to put beauty in the words. Nature is the greatest blessing from the God. It's immortal and never become nothingness. Its beauty increases day by day. By discovering nature, you discover yourself. Hello, my dear friends. First, let me introduce myself. I am Fiza Biju. Well, today's topic is about the struggles that experiencing by nature and how to conserve our nature. Why we are going to talk about this issue? Because how an individual can bring an impact to cause a change. For instance, to conserve our resources, many actions can be taken by person to person level. We cannot stop natural disasters, but we can arm ourselves. I called Maria Sneha George to tell us about natural disasters around us.
Natural disaster. A natural disaster means a disaster that is completely natural. It can occur in any time. This disaster includes many types of disasters like earthquakes, volcanic eruption, tsunamis, etc. Due to these disasters, natural property and the all creatures in the world are at great risk. How natural disasters take place? A natural disaster are caused due to the different reasons like seismic activities, soil erosion, tectonic movements, ocean currents and air pressures, etc. The natural activities taking place in the crust of the earth as well as a surface are the main reasons for this disaster. Thank you.
I call Alna to tell us about how man-made disasters take place.
Man-made disasters take place. Man-made disasters are the result of carelessness or human errors during technological and industrial use. It is difficult to predict. However, they are preventable with a little vigilance. They shouldn't occur in the first place. Events such as gas leaks, oil spills, nuclear meltdowns, and industrial fire transpire through human errors and carry grave consequences.
Hi friends, I am Sneha Santosh. I am going to speak about effects that causes by man-made disasters. It may be becomes explosion, earthquake, floods, hurricanes or fires in a disaster. You may face the danger of death or physical injury. You may also lose your home, position and community. Such stressors you place you at risk for emotional and physical health problems. Thank you.
Next, we are going to see posters about natural disasters drawn by Amala and Devuti.
Morning friends, I am Devuti.
My topic is natural disasters. Thank you.
Friends, I am Amala.
My topic is natural conservation.
I called Esther to tell us about nature conservation.
Hi dear friends, I am Esther. My topic is natural conservation. Hope all knows about natural conservation. Let me speak a few words about conservation. Conservation is the care and protection of these resources so that they can preserve for future generations. Conservation seeks the sustainable use of nature by human, while preservation means protecting nature from human use. Thank you.
Some call me nature. Others call me Mother Nature. I have been here for over 4.5 billion years, 22,500 times longer than you. I don't really need people, but people need me. Yes, your future depends on me. When I try, you try. When I falter, you falter. Or worse. But I have been here for eons. I have fed species greater than you. I have starved species greater than you. My oceans, my soil, my flowing streams, my forests, then all can take you or leave you. How you choose to live each day, whether you regard or disregard me, doesn't really matter to me. One way or the other way, your actions will determine your fate, not mine. I am nature. I will go on.